we'd like to talk a little bit about the dental implant history. And for me, it's quite exciting and interesting. The fact that implants, we can say, have been around only for a few years. But in reality, implants has been around for thousands of years. It's just what you put in the mouth. We know George Washington had probably wooden tooth or teeth to ivory and you name it. In the Egyptian era or in the Aztec era, they found that they were placing in from little small rocks to little small bone and even gold pieces embedded into the bone, thinking that it will stick or bond. So implants really is anything that is a foreign object that we place in our jaw or in our mouth. To the misfortune of those generations thousands of years ago, or even to our father of our country, they don't work too well because they just don't stay in there that well, not knowing the science behind it. So the real birth, so to say, of dental implant came in the 50s by the name of Dr. Brennemar. He was a physician, he wanted to test to see how basically metal and bone can they bond together. And it was the design, now we look at it today, of what he did was quite archaic, but at that time was, of course, it was phenomenal. The first thing he did, he worked on a canine, and he extracted the canine's teeth, and then placed implants in the canine's jawbone, and then refabricate these brand new teeth. They're solid metal, coming through the canine's gum. It's just phenomenal. That picture, just when you look at it, you think of that 007 jaw, the guy who has all metal teeth. But this one, the canine was more ferocious. It has all these metal teeth, a nice sharp point. With that one experiment, and many others, of course, but mainly with that one experiment, it proves that metal can bond to the bone can bond to the metal, and so that in that fact, things started changing. And we realized that, but then how we were supposed to do it was really a learning curve, and not knowing really what type of metal bonds well. We tried from everything. They have used from stainless steel to solid gold to finally titanium, which is the metal of choice, knowing that titanium is very compatible biologically with our body. And so, but they have to kind of go through that series of trial and error. But now with titanium, even though it's medical grade, they have many different grades. There are many different designs on them. And so from the 50s to the 60s to the 70s, that's what they were doing. They were just sticking these different kind of metals in people's mouth, and some work and most didn't. And in the dental profession, people were looking at implantologists as quacks. They're crazy, they're hurting patients. But the fact that because of what they were doing in these experiments, it really helped basically improve the technology and the hunger for making it better.